Here we are, and Lenny Solomon live. Yes, indeed, the 189th show. A little bit of a different show tonight than usual. I'm not going to be playing keyboard. We will show a music video, and I will sing one song a cappella. But really, tonight's show is a Holocaust Remembrance show, because here in Israel already, it's 11 o'clock at night here in Israel, and it is Yom HaShoah. It is the Holocaust Remembrance Day here in Israel. Here we are in the Four Corners Project studio here in Beit Shemesh. Let's get our sign up. Here we go. It's our Four Corners Project studio here in Beit Shemesh, Israel. And tonight is Holocaust Remembrance Day, and we are going to feature one of the songs that I made a music video about, talk about the video, and talk about Bobbi Hinda. Bobbi Hinda was my grandmother. I had two Bobbies. I had Bobbi Hinda. She was from Bessarabia in Romania. And my other Bobby is Bobbi Malka. She was from Poland, specifically Tarnów, that area. And then, of course, I had Zadi Pesach. He was also from Tarnów. And Grandpa Harry, who actually was born in New York, but his parents came from Bialystok, which is also Poland. Okay, so now you basically get the picture. We're talking about Zadi Pesach was born in 1895, Bobbi Malka in 1896, and in 1902, Bobbi Hinda was born. Now, in my song, in Still Not Quite on Broadway, I say Bobbi Hinda was born child number two. Truthfully, she was daughter number two, not child number two. There were a lot of kids. I don't know what number she actually was, but she had an older sister. Now, so tonight's show features a little bit of a dive into Transnistria. What was Transnistria? Have you ever heard of Transnistria? Did you know that it was a concentration area? It's not even called the concentration camp. It's a concentration area. And they killed 400,000 Jews there. Romania, Hungary. They put them all in an area and they starved them to death. The worst possible death you could imagine, because not even gas chambers, just no food. So they all died. They just all died. They starved to death. And they also died from typhus. Not a lot of fun. This is not a tremendously fun show tonight. But, you know, we will find something to give us hope by the end of this show, I hope. Let me just see. Judy Hertzfeld is checking in. You'll notice there's no hockey jersey tonight, Judy. There's no baseball jersey because it's Holocaust Remembrance Day. We will be solemn today. We will not be Solomon. We will be solemn. And we will be wearing a black polo. So, and no baseball cap or hockey cap. So here we are. It's Holocaust Remembrance Night tonight. And let's go back and discuss the life of Bobbi Hinda. Oh, Natana checking in from Nahariya, I believe. Hi, Natana. So here we are. Bobbi Hinda, my grandmother, Bobbi Hinda, she was born in a city called Otaki, O-T-A-C-I, which is in Romania. Now, it went back and forth. Romania, Moldova, Moldova, Romania, right? And that was the way it was also in Poland, where my Zadi Pesach was born. Poland wasn't Poland. There was no such thing as Poland. It was Hungary. It was part of other countries. You know, they would always lose in battles. But anyway, Bobbi Hinda, when she was seven, she almost drowned in a river, and she was pulled out by her long hair. She had long hair. They pulled her out, and she was a spunky soul, spunky, perky Bobbi, you know, grandmother. Bobby's grandmother, by the way. So she grew up in Romania. Not a great existence. If you think about it, I was born in 1961, and fabulous time to grow up and to live. For a guy, for a boy, even for a girl, obviously, but for a boy like myself, sports and friends and shul and everything and life was brilliant. But I'm not sure it was like that in Romania. Actually, I know it wasn't good. Who the hell wanted to be living in Romania in the year 1902? You didn't. Anyway, so Bobbi Hinda, now here's what's happened. She has an older sister. Now, my great-grandfather, his name was Aryeh Leib. What's my Hebrew name? Aryeh Leib. I'm named after my great-grandfather, meaning my grandmother, my Bobbi Hinda's father. That's who I'm named after. So he pays for papers to send Bobbi Hinda's oldest sister. Her name was Tuba, T-O-U-B-E-H, which is a Yiddish word, which means Yonina or dove in English. You know, Yonah. Yonah is dove. So this is Yonina. And Bob, you know, Aryeh Leib, my great-grandfather, pays for papers to send Tuba to America. Problem, Tuba dies. She got some sort of illness, some sort of disease. She passes away. So in the middle of the night, Aryeh Leib goes to my grandmother, Bobbi Hinda, and he says to her, Hinda, die willst fahren zu Amerika? So he says to Hinda, Hinda, you want to go to America? And my grandmother says, yo, yes. So there we go. Bobbi Hinda is off to America. And she has the paperwork. She looks enough like her older sister that she passes for her older sister. Interesting, right? Now, Bobbi Hinda comes. This is 1927. So she's 25 years old now. And Bobbi Hinda leaves Romania and comes to Philadelphia. Philadelphia is where her cousin Bryna was. Now, cousin Bryna was not pleased, putting it mildly. She wanted Tuba. She wanted to see my grandmother's older sister. That's who she paid the money for her to come to America. Finding out that Tuba was no longer alive, she, in a fit of rage or anger, turns to Bobbi Hinda and says, I paid a lot of money for Tuba to come, and you came instead. You are going to work, and you're going to pay me back. You are going to pay me back for the money that I spent to bring you over to America. And that's what happens. So Bobbi Hinda's first, you know, let's say, experience in America was not good. Now, Shirley, I would say hello to Shirley Shaffron. He actually helps us with our websites. Great to see you, Shirley. Now, so here we are, Bobbi Hinda's in Philadelphia. Cousin Bryna has not given her such a great welcome. And the year is 1927. She's 25 years old. Anyway, she finally gets married in 1932, and she marries Grandpa Harry. Harry's Hebrew name was David Tzvi. In Yiddish, it was Tzvi Hersh. You know, you have a lot of these double names, Yiddish, Tzvi and Hersh. Hersh is a Tzvi. Aryeh Leib. Leib is an Aryeh. Dov, bear. Dov is a bear. Got it? A lot of those. So, anyway, Grandpa Harry marries Bobbi Hinda. And my grandmother called him Herschel. Herschel! Come here, Herschel. She spoke with a Yiddish accent, as you could well imagine. She was really fun, Bobbi Hinda. So, anyway, in 1934, my mother is born, and in 1939, my Aunt Marcia was born. Bobbi Hinda gave birth to two children. Now, here's the kicker. This is the kicker. The kicker is the entire family. Now, Bobbi Hinda's maiden name was Naslavsky. Her name was Hinda Naslavsky. Bobbi Hinda's mother's maiden name was Melnikov. So the Melnikov and the Naslavsky family in Romania all died in the Holocaust, except for one person. Actually, not true. two people, Hinda and her brother Ezra. Ezra marries Rosie and goes to Rio de Janeiro, but they never had any children. Bobbi Hinda marries Grandpa Harry Herschel. She has two children. So very, very interesting. Very interesting. So the only branches from these two family trees that make it out of Romania are who? My mother, Tube, who my grandmother names my mother after her older sister. After all, she came to America on that, on her papers. And Aunt Marcia. Marcia, her Hebrew name was Masarifka. Masarifka. So, here's the scoop. So, now we're going to take a break for a second, and we are going to play Transnistria, the song. And then I'm going to tell you all about Transnistria and what happened and all that great stuff. Okay, here is Transnistria from Schlockrock, the album New Shul. Oops. Oh, well. There we go. Let's go back to that song.
Thank you.
Okay, we're back. I heard that the sound wasn't so good. I apologize for that. I don't know why 100%. So the only thing I could tell you is you can watch it on YouTube. It's on YouTube. Just type in Schlock Rock Transnistria, and it'll come up. Maybe if you're a subscriber to the Four Corners Project or Schlock Rock, I think it's on both of those. Well, what can you do? Best laid plans, as they say. But the song is, the volume is perfect on YouTube, and I guess for some reason it was not strong here. I don't know why. But once we get our new studio with our tech people, it's going to be amazing. When is that going to happen? It's going to happen when you go to www.fourcornersproject.org and place a donation to support the work of the Four Corners Project. Because everything that happens right now comes because of the Four Corners Project and Hashem. Not in that order. God first, Four Corners Project second, and then hopefully my creativity third, which God, thank God, has given me some creativity. So you can watch it on YouTube. Go to Schlock Rock Transnistria and watch it. You'll see the whole video. Back to Transnistria and back to Bobbi Hinda. So Bobbi Hinda gets married, has two children. Now here's the thing. There was a brother named either Yaakov or Shlomo, I can't remember. He actually had left Romania, but he couldn't handle it, and he went back. Bad move. What can you do? It's hard to leave where you grow up. Meanwhile, Uncle Ezra goes to Rio de Janeiro, never has any children. He's married to Rosie, very nice lady. I never really met them in person. I might have met them in person, but they would communicate with my grandmother and my mother through letters. Now, letters, you guys know what letters are? It's like this thing where you write a letter and then you mail it. Anyway, nowadays nobody knows what a letter is. So that ended. My grandmother gets this letter in 1945, 44, 43, that all of her family had died in Transnistria. I remember my mother telling me the story about how sad it was. No words. What was Transnistria like? They didn't give you food. They didn't give you food. They didn't give you anything. People died from typhus, and they died from starvation. Things were so bad, they would eat the dead bodies. That's how bad it was. It's like Eicha. In Eicha, they talk about that. It was bad. After all, 6 million Jews died. But here's the thing. The Romanians cover it up. They say they didn't do anything wrong. They were just, it was the Germans. It was not the Germans. It was the Romanians. Don't ever forget it. It was the Romanians. It was especially the head, Ian Antonescu, who was working with Hitler. May their names be blotted out. So the point is, Transnistria was an evil place. Transnistria, believe it or not, became its own independent state. And Russia just went through Transnistria to get into Ukraine. Can you believe that? So Transnistria is back. But anyway, the point is, Bobbi Hinda names my mother Tube after her older sister who had passed away at a young age. And my Bobbi Hinda says, oh my God, I named her after somebody that died young. So she takes my mother to a rabbi and says, Rabbi, what should I do? I named her after my sister, but my sister died young. So the rabbi looks at my mother and goes, Chai Tube, Chai, live. And that was her name. Her name became Chai dash Tube. Chai meaning live, live Tube, live. And my mother, thank God, is still alive now. Baruch Hashem. So that's the story of that's the story of Bobbi Hinda. Bobbi Hinda died at 92 years old in 1994. And on Simchat Torah. So, but the great thing about Bobbi Hinda was that she continued the legacy of the Maslovsky and the Melnikov family. And then my mother had three children. My Aunt Marcia never got married, but and she's still alive, thank God. But my mother had three kids, and we are the branches of the Naslavsky and the Melnikov family going back to Romania. We are those branches. So me, my brother, and my sister, we continue. And we do the job of the Jew. The job of the Jew, which is to be a light unto the nations and to tell everybody, God rules the world. And at some point, the world is going to recognize God. And we will see. We will see great things. So that was the first thing I wanted to do for today's show. We're already 22 minutes in. I'm not going to do so much more. I just want to recommend this book. If you're into books about Gilgulim, reincarnated souls, this is a book called I've Been Here Before by Sarah Yocheved Riegler. It's available on Amazon. I got it, I think, on Amazon. Oh, no, I didn't. I got it here through in Israel through the Judaica Book Center and Michael Rose. If you live in Israel, best place to get anything. Judaica Book Center. So this book called I've Been Here Before is a fantastic book of people that were haunted by dreams, recurring dreams over and over and over again because they were in the Holocaust. They died in the Holocaust and things and how it affected them and what they had to do to get by and get, you know, because it's unusual to have stuff like this happen. But I've always felt like I was in the Holocaust too. But I don't really have any proof. The closest thing I have is I once went to see Yom HaShoah at MetLife Stadium. Not this past one. I think the one before it. And when I was in a train, I had a flashback that I was in a train, you know, a cattle car in Germany. But it was like a 3-second flashback. And I spoke to somebody about it. And I said, Lenny, you're one of like thousands of people that probably had those flashbacks. So I don't know. I don't really have any stories that I can tell you that I was a reincarnated soul from the Holocaust, but there were a lot of them. There had to have been. 6 million Jews died, right? In my feeling is, and my theory is that God, you know, took the souls, these 6 million souls, and said, now get back down and do it again. And this time you're going to have to move to Israel, and I'm going to make your life great. And he did. Growing up in 1961, as I was telling you before, fabulous time to grow up, fabulous time to you know, just the technology, everything, and the sports, and the life, and it's just, you know, and here we are in the year 2022, and now it's complicated. The last 3 years have been very complicated. Anyway, so I wanted to plug this book. I've Been Here Before, Sari Yocheved Riegler. I also wanted to sing one song a cappella. This is the Ani Mamin that was sung on a train, and it went around the world. In other words, a guy wrote this Ani Mamin and sang it on a train. You know it, because you've been singing it in your synagogue, in your temple, forever. And it goes like this. Ani Mamin, Ani Mamin, Ani Mamin. Bemuna shelema biviat hamashiach biviat hamashiach ani mamin vi afal bi sheyit mameya im kol zeachakelo ani mamin. Everybody together. Ani mamin, ani mamin, ani mamin, beemuna sheleima, biviat hamashiach, biviat hamashiach, ani mamin. Vi afal bi sheyit mameya im kol zeachakelo ani mamin. There we go. The train Ani Mamin, the song written in the cattle cars, or he either composed it in the cattle cars or he just taught it to everybody and then died, and then it went around the world and everybody knows it. Could you imagine that? Everybody knows that Ani Mamin. And it is the train Ani Mamin. So we want to say hello to Yudi Silber from Cleveland. Hope you're doing good, Yudi. Thanks for chiming in. Listen, you guys, If you're watching from Facebook, four channels, Lenny Solomon English, Lenny Solomon Hebrew, Schlock Rock page, Four Corners Project page. If you're watching from YouTube, Schlock Rock channel, Four Corners Project channel, make sure you subscribe. Make sure you give us all great comments, thumbs up. Let us know what's going on. If you're watching from LinkedIn, Lenny Solomon LinkedIn, you can say hello and make some comments. And, of course, Twitter, at Lenny Solomon, retweet. This has been an interesting show, but I will tell you this. Bobbi Hinda's life was a great life. We never really knew. I never really knew the type of life she led. She didn't tell us. She lived with a spunky life, with a will to live. She lived the longest out of all the grandparents, 92 years old. And this one's for you, Bobbi Hinda. She was the best. Of course, Bobby Malka was the best too, and so was Zadie Pesach. But we'll tell you about those grandparents another time. And of course, Grandpa Harry Herschel was also fabulous. They were great grandparents. Great. Okay, I think we've reached the end of our show on a Holocaust Remembrance Night. Remember, everybody, it is the time for the Jewish people to rise. But what's the secret? The secret is unity. The secret is achdut. If we do not get along, this thing ain't going to happen so quickly, and it's going to be painful. So I would think that we have to work on getting along. All right, keep on schlocking, everybody. Lenny Solomon Live, show number 189, over and out. We'll see you tomorrow night with a musical show. We're working our way towards Yom HaShoah, Israel Independence Day, and then after that we will do interviews. We will do interviews during the time between Yom HaShoah and Lag BaOmer. Okay? Keep on schlagging. Have a great, great day, and see you tomorrow night. On Lenny Solomon Live, show number 189 is a wrap.